Oh, sorry.
Good morning, everyone.
Good morning.
I'm gonna use the microphone for you folks back there. I know it's very difficult to hear, and I'm gonna try to use my outside voice. My Aunt Maverine made being unique look beautiful.
Yeah.
As the matriarch of our family, she shouldered the weight of our blessings and our challenges on her shoulders. She stepped into the gap for so many of us. She was so strong that we almost thought she was invincible.
Amen. Wonder Woman.
I never knew my aunt as a young person. In fact, she was just about my age when I was born. So I began to wonder what life must have been like for her. What had she seen in her 97 years?
Wow.
Born in 1920. I'm going to get through this. Born in 1920. It was the year of the beginning of the Negro Baseball League.
Yeah.
It was the beginning of the National Football League for all you guys in the room. It was called the American League at that time. It was the beginning of Zeta Phi Beta for all of our Greek sisters and brothers in the room. And it was the year that women earned the right to vote. My auntie lived through the Roaring Twenties, through the Great Depression of the 30s, through segregation, to the Civil Rights Movement, and she lived long enough to see the first black president.
All right.
Those eyes, they held so much history, our history. My earliest memories of Maverine at MAB. Well, first let me say she's the meanest usher I ever met. Tell the truth. And none of us wanted to be the source of her attention.
Hello.
Whether it was a pop, a handout for your gum, or even a mean side eye, nobody wanted that. She kept us in line in these pews. I remember club meetings at my Aunt Maverine's house. We would all be packed into that house. I thought it was a mansion. Now we know if we rolled by there today, we have a different perception. But my cousins and I would be running wild. The grown-ups would be doing whatever you do at club meeting. I still haven't figured that out. But mostly they'd be eating. And I want to say they're telling the truth, but I think that might have been a few lies. I don't know what trips to Augusta look like without a stop to St. John Tower.
Amen.
Between my aunts, we've been a part of that tower for over 34 years. To sit and have lunch with her and her 90-year-old friend. And learn that their drama is not that different than ours.
That's right.
We would even drag the kids out of bed, bring your electronics, dress in layers, because we don't know how hot it's going to be in Aunt Mab's apartment. And it was really hot on occasion, let me tell you. I'm blessed to be able to travel around the world to represent this country, to have worked for the first black president. And people often wonder where my confidence lies. And sometimes they're bold enough to ask. I tell them, I'm from a family of strong black women.
Come on now.
There isn't a shrinking flower amongst us. And those who have an opportunity to experience any one of us often wonder, who do they think they are? And some have the audacity to ask. Well, we know who we are.
Come on now.
Because she knew who she was. Auntie Nita Bell knew who she was. All right. Grandma Belle knew who she was.
Amen.
Now it's up to us, all of us, to make sure that that next generation knows who they are.
Amen.
Rest well, Auntie Maverick. We're going to miss you, but we got you.